Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about first law of thermodynamics as well as we have did a mathematical expression of that too. So now we are going to study about what is second law of thermodynamics and let us explain it. So let us do it. So friends, now let us start what does the second law of thermodynamics means. So the statement are as follows. It says that the second law of thermodynamics says that heat cannot be completely converted into an equivalent amount of work without producing permanent changes either in the system or its surrounding. So what does it say? That in the first law of thermodynamics that we have did as well as we have did a few applications of the first law of thermodynamics in isochoric process, in isobaric process as well as adiabatic and isothermal. But in that case, what this law says is we cannot convert the amount of heat to equivalent amount of work. This indicates that there will be a certain kind of change either in the system or in the surrounding. So that kind of permanent change will occur. That is a statement of second law of thermodynamics. So yes, there are another statement also so that we could understand it in a more better way. It says that the spontaneous flow of heat is always unidirectional from high temperature to low temperature. Again, this is a second law of thermodynamics state this thing. So let us talk about this one, that is the second law of thermodynamics, by explaining it. So let me explain you by giving you a few examples of that so that we could understand. The second law of thermodynamics helps to predict whether the reaction is feasible or not. So this second law of thermodynamics also gives us the information whether the reaction can or whether the process will move on in a smooth way or not. So that is means readily, that means it can move in a by its own or not, or how much ease will be the process that it will move from one form to another form. So it also gives the information about the flow of heat, that is, as you know, because the heat will flow from high temperature when of a body with has a high temperature to a body which has a low temperature. And according to the second law of thermodynamics, energy cannot be completely converted into equivalent work. That is what the first statement of, that is the second law of thermodynamics was, had made a statement in that we have made that the heat cannot be converted into equivalent work, or any kind of energy won't be converted to its equivalent work, but yes, there would be certain kind of change that would occur in the system or in the surrounding. So for that, another statement or another kind of expression, it would be very much clear to understand this thing, that is, the efficiency of a machine will be unity if heat absorbed by it is completely converted into work without producing changes in the system. So this is possible, means we could convert the heat to work, but to an equivalent work. So the heat energy has been totally converted into work energy, and this states that for making the efficiency one, we have to convert all those heat to work. But that is not possible because we have not very familiar to a kind of machine which is showing an efficiency of one, because all those heat energy that are being supplied to the system, that is not been completely converted, that is 100% converted to work. It would give us less work, less than 100%, but yes, there would be certain kind of change. So therefore, it says that according to the second law of thermodynamics, no machine has yet been made that has an efficiency of unity. And in this case, efficiency means nothing but the amount of heat that we provide to the ratio, the work done by the process. So in this case, the work done during this process will be one, or the efficiency will be one, making the work as 100%. So this is not possible according to the second law of thermodynamics. So this is what the second law of thermodynamics states about. It is based on the energy, the conversion of energy that is from one form to another form, but it won't be converted completely unless it does a permanent change in the system or the surrounding. So that is what second law of thermodynamics states. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this statement very clearly. And yes, share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.